Today I wanted to discuss an article that was in Christianity Today back in 2016 written by Caleb Langren called Evangelicals' Favorite Heresies Revisited by Researchers. And this was pointed out to me by a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints who was trying to prove the point, and I can see why. That a lot of the things that we condemn their church for believing or members of the church for believing are actually being believed by many who claim to be not only Christian but also evangelicals. And just to clarify, the article clarifies evangelicals as those who believe the Bible has the highest authority for belief, that personal evangelism is very important, that Jesus' death is the only way to cancel the penalty of sin, and that trusting in Jesus is the only way of salvation. And so among those who were polled, and they said there was about 3,000 who fit into this category of evangelicals, 74% of them said that individuals must contribute to their own salvation. That is, 3 out of 4 evangelicals said that you must contribute to your own salvation. 71% said that Jesus is the first and greatest being created by God. 56% said the Holy Spirit is a force, not a personal being. 54% said everyone sins, but most people are good by nature. 48% said God accepts the worship of all religions. 39% said my good deeds help to earn my place in heaven. 37% says that God will always reward faith with material blessings. Now, it's interesting to note that it's very obvious that why my LDS friend pointed that article to my attention, because all of those are things that they might word it differently, or it might be a little bit different in the way that they believe, but the LDS Church believes pretty much all of those things. Some of those are more Jehovah's Witness or one of the other groups that we discuss on this channel in origin, but this is really disturbing. And it's something that I've been pointing out. I did another video with my friend Michael Bohm on his podcast, Youth Apologetics Training. It's also on this channel. You can check it out. Are Christians becoming more LDS? Kind of putting a flip on the whole, are Mormons becoming Christian? And are Christians becoming more LDS? And taking a look at some of the things that I see that are going on, false beliefs that are being spread very rapidly. And this just really understates the fact that Christians just don't seem to read, study, or know their Bible. They don't know what they believe. And it's not being helped by churches and pastors who are preaching sermons that are more story than they are Bible. And people just don't know what it is that they believe. And if this continues, it's going to be harder and harder to point to groups that are teaching false doctrine and say that they are not Christian, or clarify the confusion that is out there when mainline Christian doctrines, denominations, all of these things are teaching these types of things. And if they're not teaching these types of things, the people who are attending those churches are believing these things. And so I want to know what your comments are on this article, and if there's other things that you would like for me to look at, discuss. I really don't even know how to respond other than that's not what the Bible says. That's not at all what the Bible says or what historic Christianity has taught. The idea that we must obtain our own salvation or contribute to it, at least the idea that Jesus is a created being versus being co-equal, co-eternal with God, sharing all of the attributes of God, one being, three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So I want to know, like I said, what your thoughts are, what your questions are, and what topics you would like for me to discuss in the future. This is People with a Free Gift, where we ground believers in their identity in Christ and equip them to reach those caught in religion. And I encourage you to subscribe if you haven't already, and give us a thumbs up if you like the content for today, and share this video with others who enjoy content related to cults and how to share the gospel with them. And until next time, may God's grace be with you.